Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about SymPy for algebraic and calculus computation. A very important concept in calculus is the limit of a function. This notation represents the limit of function f of x when x approaches a point x0. We can implement it using SymPy. Let's first import all the functions from SymPy and create three symbolic variables x, y, and z. Also, we turn on the pretty printing mode. This limit is implemented using the limit function. In this example, fx is sine x over x. We want to calculate the limit when variable x approaches 0. The result is 1. This example will calculate the limit of x when x approaches infinity. The answer is just infinity. This example computes the limit of 1 over x when x approaches infinity. The answer is 0. This one computes the limit of x to the power of x when x approaches 0. The answer is just 1. We can also compute the limits from a specific direction. This notation represents the limit of fx when x approaches x0 from the positive side. The second notation represents the limit of fx when x approaches x0 from the negative side. To implement these, we still use a limit function. In this example, the function is 1 over x. We want to compute the limit when x approaches 0 from the positive side. The result is positive infinity. In this example, we want to compute the limit when x approaches 0 from the negative side. The result is negative infinity. SymPy provides this diff function to compute the differentiation or derivatives of continuous functions. The first order derivative of fx can be denoted in these two different forms. In this example, we'll compute the first order derivative of sine x with respect to x. The result is cosine x. In this example, we compute the first order derivative of sine 2x with respect to x. The result is 2 times cosine x. The diff function can also be used to compute the higher order derivatives. The third parameter will be the order. In this example, we compute the first order derivative of sine 2x with respect to x. The result is 2 times cosine 2x. In this example, we compute the second order derivative of sine 2x with respect to x. The result is negative 4 times sine 2x. In this example, we'll compute the third order derivative of sine 2x with respect to x. The result is negative 8 times cosine 2x. In calculus, the indefinite integral of a function f is denoted by this expression. The integral of fx when x is from negative infinity to positive infinity. We can also use SymPy integrate function to implement this. In this example, we want to compute the indefinite integral of this function, 6 times x to the power of 5, where x is a variable. The result is x to the power of 6. In this example, we want to compute the indefinite integral of this sine x, where x is a variable. The result is negative cosine x. In this example, we want to compute the indefinite integral of the logarithm of x with base e, where x is a variable. The result is x times the logarithm of x with base e minus x. In this example, we want to compute the indefinite integral of 2x plus the hyperbolic sine x, where x is a variable. The result is x squared plus the hyperbolic cosine x. Unlike the indefinite integral, a definite integral has a lower limit a and an upper limit b. In this example, we calculate the definite integral of x cubed, where x is from negative 1 to positive 1. The result is 0. In this example, we calculate the definite integral of sine x, where x is from 0 to pi over 2. The result is 1. In this example, we calculate the definite integral of cosine x, where x is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. The result is 2. In this example, we calculate the definite integral of e to the power of negative x, where e is the Euler's number and x is from 0 to infinity. The result is 1. In this example, we calculate the definite integral of e to the power of negative x squared, where x is from negative infinity to positive infinity. This is equivalent to an indefinite integral. The result is the square root of pi. A very important concept in calculus is that a function can be approximated by using a finite number of terms of its Taylor series at a point. We can use this to find the approximate value of a function at a point. In this example, we calculate the approximate value of the natural logarithm of x at point 1. We omit the terms with order higher than the fourth degree and represent them using the big O notation. This is the result. We can see the items of the zeroth order, the first order, the second order, and the third order. The items of the fourth or higher orders are here inside the big O notation. In this example, we calculate the approximate value of the cosine x at point 0. We omit the terms with order higher than the sixth degree and represent them using the big O notation. This is the result. We can see the items of the zeroth order, the second order, and the fourth order. The items of the sixth or higher orders are here inside the big O notation. Because we didn't specify the point and the order, this series function will use the default value 0 and 6. We can use SymPy to solve polynomial and differential equations using the solve function. In this example, we solve the equation with the left-hand side represented by this expression, x squared minus 3x plus 2. The right-hand side is always 0. We want to solve for x. The output shows there are two roots, 1 and 2. In this example, we solve the system of equations. For the first equation, the left-hand side is represented by this expression, x plus 5y minus 2. For the second equation, the left-hand side is represented by this expression, minus 3x plus 6y minus 15. The right-hand sides of both equations are always 0. We want to solve for x and y. The output shows that x is negative 3 and y is 1. In this example, we solve the equation with the left-hand side represented by this expression, e to the power of x plus 1. The right-hand side is always 0. We want to solve for x. The output shows the result is I times pi. This is a complex number, and I means this is the imaginary part. Now let's define a polynomial, f equals x to the power of 4 minus 3 times x squared plus 1. The factor function will transform this polynomial into factorized and irreducible terms. As a result, it is equal to the product of two terms. We convert this f to a symbolic function using symbols. This parameter says the class of this object is function. After that, we can write the function in this way, f parentheses x. The output confirms that this is indeed a function now. Fx dot def x means we will calculate the first order derivative of fx with respect to x. Def xx means we will calculate the second order derivative of fx with respect to x. Then we add fx to this expression. The result is the left-hand side of an ordinary differential equation, ODE. The right-hand side is 0. It contains just one independent variable, x. Finally, we use the dsolve function to solve this differential equation for fx. This is the result. C1 and C2 are two arbitrary constant numbers. We can substitute a symbol in an expression with a real number using the subs function. For example, this expression is x squared plus 2x plus 1. We substitute x with 2, so the expression will be 2 squared plus 2 times 2 plus 1. It is equal to 9. If we substitute x with y plus 1, this will be the new expression. Now let's create two symbols, n and k. They're both integers. A equals factorial n. The output is n factorial. We substitute n with 3. It means 3 factorial. 3 times 2 times 1 equals 6. This binomial function will create a binomial coefficient. The output is n choose k. It means from n different numbers, we choose k numbers. How many ways can we do this? We substitute n with 3 and k with 2. From 3 numbers, choose 2 numbers. We have a total of 3 different ways to do this. This expression involves 3 symbolic variables, x, y, and z. It's x cubed plus 4xy minus z. We substitute x with 2, y with 4, and z with 0. The result is 40. Finally, we can convert a string like this to a SymPy expression using the SymPy function. So the result is a valid symbolic expression. Don't get confused with another function, SymPy, which is used for expression simplification. The capital letter S is a function that can do the same thing. So here the result is the same. Okay, that was how to use SymPy for algebraic and calculus computation. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.